Okay, this morning our session is going to be on religion and rationality. Majority of thinking youngsters, if they're already brainwashed, you can't interact with them. But majority of thinking youngsters have great difficulty in relating to the idea of God or the idea of religion as well. This is true for Hindus as well as non-Hindus. This is reality. As the youngsters have been allowed to think for themselves and challenge any idea they are given, they're kind of dished out to them, the idea of religion too is under challenge, and under the glare of rationality, it is beginning to shudder. This is reality. So what is the response and what are the various issues that we want to explore? It's a very important session for you today. Because this is the most engaging session you can ever have in religions or religious studies. Okay, first of all, there are three groups of people that we encounter. One, of course, are the theists, means who believe in a theos, an ultimate reality as a god figure in the heaven or wherever. These are the theists. Theos means a god, ultimate, a supreme personality. Then there are a second group of people who are called agnostics. The agnostic word is very interesting. It is in fact derived from Sanskrit. You'll be surprised. The Sanskrit word is gnan, which means to know. And from the word gnan, it became ancient Greek, gno. And the G became silent. It became no in English, no, knowledge. So agnostic, in front of it means no, not knowable. So agnostics are those people who say we are not sure about God. Now, agnostics come in two flavors. You'll be surprised. There are those agnostics who said, well, we've heard about God and we are sitting on the fence, we can't be sure about it. Maybe it exists, maybe it doesn't exist. But there are a second kind of more mature agnostic who say, the way you are defining the idea of God means that it cannot be understood in material terms or, if you like, in this kind of empirical terms. So it will always be unknowable. There's a big difference. Those who say we're sitting on the fence, we are not sure whether we agree with them, with this idea of God. And those who say, the way you define God, it'll be impossible to, if you like, give empirical evidence about it, so he'll always remain unknowable, agnostic. These are the two flavors of agnostics. It's interesting for you to see the variation. The third kind of people that you encounter, and this is going to be majority of youngsters you're going to encounter in universities and a place of work, are atheists. A theist means we don't believe in a God. We are sure there is no God. So you see, just as the people who theists who say we are sure there is a God, the people who say atheists who say we are sure there is no God. And this is Richard Dawkins. And also, you will find, this is the British Humanist Association, a majority of them are atheists. Not all, some are agnostics. So these are the three kind of groups of people you'll encounter.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism. Sponsored by People Care, encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.